Yep, this unstable teleport plasmid is some strange. Of course it's not supposed to move by itself, but it does. Okay, let's keep following and perhaps it'll let us touch it. Okay, wait for this Houdini splicer. And then we'll keep following the unstable teleport plasmid. Okay. Now let's finish her. Yes! Well, what are you waiting for? TK her over here, and let's loot her. No, John, I don't think it's here. Let's move on. Okay. Ah, there it is. Oh, the plasmid wants to around with us. Well, it's certainly around with that splicer. Yeah, we've already been here. Whoa. Oh, we're in the water. Ah, yeah, reminds me of that bit too. Anyway, let's get that tonic while we're here. Vending expert 2. That'll decrease the price of the vending machine products. Not that you'll need it now that you're loaded. Ah, and we're back where we started. That's nice of that plasmid. Yep, she's doing what she usually does. Uses others as scapegoats for her mistakes. Yep, John. It looks like you're her whipping boy. Show her that you've revoked your sanction and will not submit to the role of a sacrificial animal. Yeah. Yeah, John, search the other room. The relay might be... No, it's in the marketing department. Yes, that direction. Yep, that room you need to search.
Anyone in the plasmid business ultimately requires the use of human test subjects. It's our dirty little secret. And to be frank, Rapture doesn't really want to know, provided the end product is sound. The volunteers were scarce, even as the economy buckled. A man named Sinclair approached us with a seemingly limitless supply. He rented them to us, bound and sedated. No questions asked.
Don't blame Sinclair. He was just a middleman. Appears that Gilbert Alexander was responsible for your condition. Oh, you forgot about the security camera. Okay, fight them off while the timer counts down. John's immune to electrical threats. Same can't be said for your splicer buddies.